following show contains adult content. It's not our intent to offend anyone, but we want to inform you that if you are a child under the age of 18 or get offended easily, this next show may not be for you. The content, opinions, and subject matter of these shows are solely the choice of your show hosts and their guests, and not those of the Entertainment Network or any affiliated stations. Any comments or inquiries should be directed to those show hosts. Thank you for listening.
Wake up, America! It's time for the Adventures of Pipeman on W4CY.com, West Palm Beach's number one internet radio station. Here's your host, the Pipeman.
That was me, the Pipe Man, here, and it's season 18, episode 12. Oh, my God. But that was me. I had to zip line from Costa Rica into the United States in order to cross the border because they're really cracking down on this border stuff. As I was zip lining, you could see behind me, all my friends were running along with me as I was zip lining. I don't know how many of them made it through. But I am here. I'm back in the pipe cave in Florida. And man, the jellyfish larva tried to stop me. The sloths were too slow to stop me. The howler monkeys were howling at me to scare me into staying. The cocodrilos, the crocodiles, tried to snap me up. Like I was kayaking. I had to kayak to the zip line to get to the border. And they were trying to... Oh, I can't even tell you the adventures. And the iguanas, they actually tried to sneak into the United States with me. And I see them here now outside the pipe cave on the island here. And the ticas, they all tried to stalk me and get the US Pipeman Groupon. We'll talk about that. However, right now, let's bring our pipe nuts on from wherever the hell they are in the world, because they're not here at the pipe cave.
No.
Not at the pipe cave.
Not at the pipe cave. But speaking of the pipe cave, okay, we have a Groupon having to do with the pipe cave. Now that I'm back, the Groupon is fully active. So, Juan, let's hear about the Groupon so people can check into it.
Are you tired of the same old bed and breakfast? Come visit the Pipe Cave, where you can service the Pipe Man all night long. And then serve the Pipe Man breakfast.
And then get the hell out.
That's the Pipe Man Groupon. The Groupon special is normally $1.99, but today it's on sale for $99. Just call into the show right now, 561-623-9429, and you too can have the Pipe Man Groupon. I had the Groupon. You should too.
So, Juan, I think I'm going to have to switch around that graphic because I wonder if that QR code works with the logo up there. So I'm going to switch it around for next week. But I just want to say the graphic's up there because the Pipe Man OnlyFans is not only active, it has content, it has subscribers. We're going to be adding more content. We've been featuring some Chef Rachel Pipe Nut content recently. Mm-hmm. We did do one piece of content that was Pipe Man content, which I show them where this was something, you know, a naked pic of them implanting a chip into my arm. And in a second, Juan's going to show that pic. And then we have some new content that's going to be uploaded after this show sometime today from Rebel Pipe Nut. And oh my God, that's some juicy shit. You're not going to want to miss it. It includes feet and douchebags, I think. I can't
There's
remember.
There's nothing of the sort of that. No. Nice try, though.
Well, no. Wasn't the one where you're like laying on the bed, wasn't that you douching yourself? Or were you
Ew!
Just or were you no. just playing with yourself?
Neither.
Oh, okay.
Neither.
What were you doing? Inquiring minds one. Yeah, but you got to create some imagination for our subscribers, okay?
It's for them to imagine what's actually going on, okay?
We'll have to see. Mm-hmm. You know, all they have to do is go to onlyfans.com/pipemanradio. Just like all my social media outlets and all my everything outlets, it's always Pipeman Radio. There's going to be news on the Pipeman Radio tour, which we'll talk about in a minute. But before that, and before we get to Chef Rachel Pipenut, because we're going to talk about her stuff and her antics, but I want one. Let's show that picture that is on the OnlyFans. The only one. Well, there's two. There's only two of the Pipe Man because nobody gives a shit about that. Well, yeah, there are because I have stalkers that are like, how come you're not posting more content up there? It's for my pipe nuts. And by the way, Juan is here with us, but he's feeling very sick. So he's kind of looking like an iguana and he decided not to come on to the video. So Juan, show us that pic. It's the one that says the Pipe Man chipped pic. There it is. There's the Pipe Man's member with a, see this right here that I can't, I'm trying to point to it, but nobody can see me pointing. It's that little sliver on the right there, like towards
yeah,
the end.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. That is the chip.
Oh, and, my God.
Yes. And you know who implanted that chip? A doctor in the United States. Okay? So I'm just saying, I had to go to another doctor, and they took this to see the chip. And I tried to get him to remove the chip. I don't know. We'll see. We had a procedure yesterday to remove the chip. And it does freaking hurt. So all you people saying you're getting chipped, unless it hurts, you're not getting chipped, okay? And I don't know. I think it's like the microphone of my phone. Doesn't it look like a microphone? I think they took the microphone from my 5G phone and put it in to my member. And that really is a picture of my member.
No, it's not.
That's yes, your toe. It
is. It's your, what are you talking about?
It's not your member. What is that, your foot?
Your member doesn't have bones. Just right. Saying.
Those are bones. That's the actual member, and the stuff on the outside of it is like the shadow. Okay, okay, remove the pick one. Okay, so
nice try,
let's hear about your content on the OnlyFans, Rachel. And I know,
let's hear about it. I can't get on it. You want
I know,
me
that's
to
the
pay thing. To get on my to get where to see my own content.
I know that's the funniest thing right there because, okay, so OnlyFans, they are the most complicated, difficult of all of them. Like. You go on the Instagram, anybody, you cannot see people's stuff unless you subscribe.
Yeah.
You know,
he wants me
not
to
even your own. I can't. I without the login, if I go in and try to see
my
stuff.
I need the login then so I can go on there. So I can post things on there.
Right. That's what I do. And I was like, okay, so Rebel, you got sent this too, but you didn't want to participate because of you didn't want to get chipped by OnlyFans, but there's something there in what I sent you guys that allowed you to actually log in. And I'm asking her. I already asked you. Okay, why don't you just sit back and show us your feet while I ask her?
Okay.
So they look great.
Yeah.
Rebel. Was there anything there that said, here, go create your login or something to actually log into it? Because I thought that's what I was doing. like your crane team members. What's the good of crane team members if they can't frickin' log in?
No, there wasn't.
So I'll just have to give you the log
stuff.
I'll have to give you guys the login later. Then I don't. That makes no sense to me. Like even on Dropbox, okay? There's team logins. Like you guys have a login for that.
I don't know, but guess what?
And I have a different login for that.
Guess what?
But
just on TikTok doing my little pre thing. I got banned on live again because
again?
Why? Yes,
because of my member.
Because I brought up. I brought up the OnlyFans. I said you could follow Pipeman Radio, and I said, look, I'm not putting anything up there that's like, you know, it's you know, they're just sexier pictures. Violation, boom. Not just
see
a violation,
that's so weird because I have so many TikTok people I see that post promoting their OnlyFans. Yeah, why do they not get banned? Mm-mm. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, they're watching me like hawk.
Well, that's because the Americans are trying to take over it. If it were the Chinese, they'd let you do whatever you want because it's over here. If you were in China, you couldn't do it. But over here, they'll let you do it because they want to smut us down so that they can take over. They're already, I learned while I was in Costa Rica, are taking over Canada. Okay. And that's a little unsettling to the pipe man because that means they're very close to us to take us over. And I bet you our current almost criminal, we say almost because there's a trial going on right now, might become the next prez. But I think, all right, so here's my idea. Let's not vote for somebody 77 and 80, number one. I don't want to vote for my condo commando president, okay? But you do want to vote for the pipe man. Don't you, Juan? I think we want to vote for the pipe man. What do you think, Rebel?
I think we do. I think we want to vote for the pipe man.
I think Bill Clinton thinks you should vote for the pipe man personally. How about you, Rachel? Are you voting for the pipe man?
I'm not voting.
We got beat. Yeah, but you got to vote for me. Yeah, we got to beat my record. In 2016, I got 5 votes plus myself.
Are you going to fire me if I don't vote for you?
Oh. No, this is a free country. You can vote for Mickey Mouse for all I care.
That's not what you
take it. Many votes.
Anybody
every
can
year.
Vote for whoever they want. The yeah, that's true. But anybody can vote for whoever they want. I want to stress that. I'm so sick and tired of this biased media that tells everybody who they should vote for, and your news is dependent on whether you're conservative or liberal. The news should be news. So here's some pipe news. The pipe man is running for president. He's hoping that what happens is Joe Biden gets so senile that he has to drop out of the race. Mm-hmm. And maybe possibly there could be a conviction to drop somebody else out of the race. OJ already died, so he can't become president. And so there's only going to be one choice left if all that happens. And we already got the OJ part. So vote Pipe Man for Prez. Roll it, Juan.
Hey, folks, this is Bill Clinton. I listen to W4CY.com. And just remember, I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
Just like Rebel didn't have sexual relations.
Bring back the good old days, and I will have sexual relations with that woman. Vote Pipe Man for Prez.
And I promise I won't have sexual relations with your cousin. Well, your cousin, not my cousin, though. I'll do your cousin, but not my cousin. Speaking of which,
you're going to do her cousin, the same one she's doing.
No.
He had that opportunity last week. He could have. Yeah.
That's right. Yeah, he went to Costa Rica to find you.
Yeah, that's why I escaped. So
my cousin is not interested.
Tell us a little bit about the content.
He likes to keep it in the family.
Tell us a little bit about your content there on the OnlyFans, Rachel. And yes, I'll tell you a little bit about what's up there. You've sent me the stuff to put up there. I haven't put it up there all.
Yeah, but you can't put it all at once. You put something on there like about the shoes or I don't know what you were adding stuff to it.
No, I didn't do anything. Verbiage. Oh, I added verbiage, but not.
Oh, God.
You could probably add better verbiage than me. I'll tell you what we're going to do. I'm right now, as we're speaking, I am pulling up the OnlyFans, and we'll pull up some of the posts.
Okay.
Can't do them all because we don't have enough time in the show. Mm-hmm. So let's see. My profile. All right. So we're going to go to the very beginning.
By the way, but y'all all should subscribe.
I'm not.
We're going all the way to the beginning. The first post we did.
We already know what we put in the
post. First post we did was for the QR code for, you know, to get on the OnlyFans. Like, I don't think you need that though. If you're already on OnlyFans, you don't need the QR code. Second one is, I didn't post any comment, is Rachel in green.
Rachel with in
two separate poses in green. So if you like green, you're going to love that. Then the next post is Rachel. And I can't show this on screen, people, because, you know, it's spicy content. But spicy. Rachel in a bunch of black and white photos. And I got to tell you.
Nothing shows my beaver. Rebel is the beaver.
But there is something that shows. I did a poll. I'm going to get to the poll.
I like
how
they chose you as the beaver.
I know, yeah, right?
You're the beaver. Okay, so then here's one that has Rachel in black and gray, and it says, "Isn't Chef Rachel Pipe Nut hot? You ain't seen nothing yet. This is just a teaser of what's to come." Then I did a poll, a quiz. I did a quiz. Okay, the quiz is that we're gonna have everybody here guess. Okay, except Rachel because she knows.
I forgot.
What bra size is Chef Rachel Pipe Nut? And here's the choices I gave. It was unanimous. The answers from all the subscribers were the exact same answer. So the first one's 38 double D. Second one is 24A.
Double D.
The third one is 52 double Z.
Wait, what?
No such thing.
Yes. And then the fourth one, which is where the subscribers are not very smart because I gave them an opportunity. I'm not done. Don't say it. Okay. Because the last one is the one that all the subscribers should have picked because then they would have gotten more content. So I'm going to say right now, if you're listening or watching, if you go in, and you send us a direct message of the fourth answer, we'll provide you some more content that may go along with that.
Will we now?
And the fourth question is whatever you want her to be. So whatever bra size you want her to be, she'll take a picture of that.
I have to ask, did anyone guess A? Because you clearly can see that. Is more than A.
I don't even know what her bra size is, so they could all
be
wrong.
She's clearly a double D.
Okay, but see, this is what he does not understand, and most men don't. You don't want a high number. That's your number, like from around here. So you don't want to be, you know, if you're 38, that means you've got a large, you know, you might be.
I know that. What man doesn't know that?
Yeah. So you ideally, what you want to be is like a 34 double D, right?
Actually, they say that the ultimate
double D, right? Or actually,
they say that the ultimate shape is 36 D. 24-36. That is supposed to be the ultimate,
you know,
hourglass
the
shape.
Ultimate changes, like,
well,
yearly.
Of course it does.
And these women that get these butt implants or, you know, the boobies, and then like a month later it's like, oh, that's gone. You gotta get that shit taken
out. I hate the fake boobies. I hate the fake butts. I hate the, and here's the thing too, okay, and by the way, Chef Rachel, hate to tell you, there was some news this morning that there's a lot of fake Botox going out there and some people have died and or are seriously ill. So I'm just giving you that.
Whatever.
Info.
I'm going to die looking young.
Well, you look young, so you don't need
that shit. And that's why I get
that shit. That's Botox. Not help. It makes people look like mannequins. Okay.
I look like a mannequin.
A little bit. I'm not going to lie. Okay.
It doesn't look like a mannequin.
I do not.
So no, anyway,
you just don't want the,
yes.
the sharp hay. See, like the it little was, wrinkles that come.
It was unanimous, Rebel. 38 double D was what everybody answered. Uh-huh. Then the next post is, hi, fans, would you like to see more? And it's her and some, like, sleeky, off-white, beigey mm-hmm. thing with boats in the background.
Uh-huh.
And then there's one that there are a lot more coming, and they will get more and more well, dot, dot, dot.
And yeah, well, not if I don't get to sign in and see.
This was the flannels. This was the flannel pics. And then there's one with her in black and a cowboy hat. Says, do you like this one? Chef Rachel Pipenut is feeling like she needs a cowboy right about now. There are a lot more coming. And then there's one that says, how about some black and white? We will be posting new content on the daily, and to our premium fans, it might even get spicier. And then there's another one that says, it looks like she's in a closet or something like that. So I put, don't put Chef Rachel Pipenut in the corner. Do you agree? And then there's one that she looks totally
goth. She's in the dungeon. Put her back in
the oddest one yet. She looks totally goth. It's just her face. Says, what do you want to see? Nice Rachel or sultry Rachel? And then there's the Pipe Man implant pic. Mm-hmm. and then there's
a picture of my barbecue.
There's one with a blue shirt on that's not buttoned that says, one of my favorite pipe nuts. Mm-hmm. And then there's another one that looks gothy too that says, she's got her tongue out. And Rachel, next time you do pics like that, brush your tongue. But it's what do you want to do with that tongue? The tongue was all white, if you can imagine what's and why she needed to brush her tongue.
It's fine. I'm not drinking. Oh my God, I'm not drinking this. Did y'all know that? I have not drank anything in 3 days. I feel
nice.
Like a whole different person.
I bet you do. Like, and that's
this
great.
Is some kind of like energy, healthy, sugar free shit.
Yeah, careful with the energy stuff because they're never really healthy.
Well, it's sugar free. It's got vitamins in it.
I think we need to. I think since I'm back and mm-hmm. I'm no longer on the home Pipe Man homeless tour, and the Pipe Man radio tour begins like this weekend.
Wow!
I think we need to talk about that, and especially because mm-hmm. I have an extremely surprise mm-hmm. special announcement.
What?
So there is a major, major music festival in South Florida. It's literally 10, 15 minutes from where the Pipe Man lives.
Awesome.
And 10, 15 minutes from the Pipe Man studio, from the mm-hmm. Talk 4 Media Studios, where mm-hmm. PipeNet One is. And this is a festival that we used to broadcast live at and do stuff at. But it's like weird this year on the tour because things that used to conflict are not conflicting. So as we started going on tour outside of Florida, this particular festival would be on the same weekend as one of our other festivals. And so I'd be at the other festival. So this year, there was no conflict. And we just got yesterday, literally, the approval from media, the first one of the first things on the Pipe Man radio tour, but we're not going to talk about it yet, is coming up very, very soon. And we're going to talk about it in a second because it's a major announcement that just happened. Okay. Awesome. But you're going to have a chance to win tickets to certain Danny Wimmer festivals. Mm-hmm. Specifically, if you call into the show today, 561-623-9429, or you direct message me on any socials, Pipe Man Radio, you can be entered to win tickets to Welcome to Rockville. We might have one or two extra ones that we held back that we're releasing because that's coming up real quick. So here's what we got, okay? April 21st, mm-hmm. Pipe Man more than likely is going to be at a club down in Fort Lauderdale, one of my favorite venues called Revolution Live, for the All My Friends North America Tour, which does include some of my friends, okay? And so let's put that banner up on the screen, Juan. So there it is. Asking Alexandria, Memphis Mayfire. I love Memphis Mayfire. good friends of mine, and they're great. The Word Alive and Nerve. It's going to be a great, 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 great show. And I'll be hanging
Look,
out.
They're coming to Houston at the House of Blues.
Oh, there you go. You got to go. It's a great one. Okay, we can get rid of that banner. Goodbye. That's this Saturday. Okay. Then we have one that we are not confirmed yet, but I'm pretty positive I'm going to be at because publicists I deal with usually always approves me if there is. I just had a question if they're going to do interviews there, because if not doing interviews, that there's no reason for me to go as working, you know. But it's the Brightside Music Festival. And this festival is badass because Sublime's going to be there. Not Sublime with Rome, but Sublime. I don't know if you know the news, people. Rebel Rachel, do you know the news about Sublime?
I do not.
What's going on?
So for many, many years, the original Sublime singer, you know, he passed away many, many years ago. So they started this thing called Sublime with Rome. Rome was a singer in a Sublime tribute band that ended up the lead singer with Sublime. Well, as of recently, Rome is going solo, and they're creating the old school Sublime, bringing the real Sublime back with the original lead singer's son as a singer, and he sounds just like him. It's like amazing. So gonna have Sublime, 311, Goldfinger, Story of the Year, Face to Face, Save Ferris, Unwritten Law, Zebrahead, and more. This is one of those cool punk festivals. It's like a punk and brew. Like, what's cool about the punk festivals is, and I don't even drink beer, but it's so cool. They give you a cup and you can try out all the different beers, and it's got all these beer stands and all that. It's going to be a lot of fun. So let's get rid of, yeah, there you go. Bond's on the ball there. So now the announcement. I am so pumped. This is the biggest festival that normally happens in South Florida, that it's so funny. All my friends go to it, and it's down on the water in West Palm Beach, downtown West Palm Beach. So it's near all the clubs and everything too, all the restaurants, but they have these party barges, and people go on the barge and they party on the intercoastal on these party barges. Then they have also, they have art vendors, so they have a whole art part of the festival. It's really cool with some of the great artists in the area. And then of course we have bands playing on multiple stages, and so we just got approved yesterday. We're doing radio coverage Sunfest here in West Palm Beach. Awesome. There it is, there's the lineup. We're gonna have our pipe nut Rebel. Let's see if she can read the lineup for us, and if we don't, have to make fun of her.
Yeah, okay? You gotta make fun of me.
So go, Rebel. You don't even have to look at your notes. Just look up at the screen, ding dong.
Okay, but I still can't see without glasses. So on Friday we have Nelly, Billy Idol, Shaggy, The Fix.
You don't know who The Fix is?
No.
Get with the program, Rebel.
They're can't big. See the tiny print. Fox Mabel Band.
Critical, Fox Mabel Band, Slow Funk Pump. Okay, Saturday, go.
Cole Swindell. Oh, wow. Cool, he's going to be there. Young Gravy. The Revitalists. Ellie King. Dylan Scott. Bryce Vine. The Aces. Paul Russell. Haley Winters. I can't see the small print.
Matt Corman, Killbillies, the Lubbin Brothers. This is why I love having Rebel read these, because it's so entertaining. Her trying to read.
I know, right?
Sunday, go Rebel.
Revolution, Third Eye Blind, Dashboard Confessional.
Madison.
I'm waiting for this one. This could be great.
Madison. Madison.
Yeah, no.
Madison.
How do you say it then?
I think it's like Madison Yahoo or something. I don't know. I don't even know how it's really popular. I don't know. Maybe Juan knows.
Win tickets if you can get that one right.
There you go. Boys Like Girls. I hope so.
Hey, you can't say that in 2024. Go.
You can.
Especially when, yeah, but especially when there's somebody like you. But go ahead. What's the rest of them?
What do you mean, me?
Well, look at you.
What about me?
Do you? Which bathroom do you use?
Duh. I'm a woman. There's no way.
Just because you put makeup on doesn't mean.
I was born with all the right parts.
Show us proof. Show us proof.
Show us the pussy.
What else do you need to see here? Look at the OnlyFans. Forget it.
Yeah,
OnlyFans.
Good move. Good move. Okay, read the rest of them. The elevators. What else?
Valley. Little Stranger. Cassidy Pope. Hey. Her too.
Hey, okay. You know why you know her, Rebel? Do you remember why you know her?
The voice.
Yeah, she was okay. She's a local where our studio is. She's a local where our studio is. She's from Wellington, and she had a punk rock band, and they went on tour, and she went on tour with Fall Out Boy and a bunch of other people. And so then she was on The Voice the same year one of my co-hosts was on The Voice, same season. And basically Cassidy won the whole thing. And then she turned country from punk. She's not even cowpunk. She's just country now. Speaking of cowpunk, Social D, some news. Mike Ness got a key to Fullerton City, like an old school punk rocker who was probably banned from the city many times, now has a key to the city, which wow. That's pretty cool.
Wow.
And I'll read the last line for you because you probably can't read it. Brothers Within, Stephen James, Serenation. Okay, so the Pipe Man's on double duty because on May 4th, okay, Sunfest, as you saw, is the 3rd through the 5th. On May 4th, I have to go to a special pub for two bands that I've interviewed already, okay? And it's one of my favorite places to go to check out live shows because they got great live shows. And they're just a great place because they're Piper's Sports Pub. I don't know if there's a relation there, but maybe there is. And that is good. Let's see that banner. One of my favorite bands of all time, Raven, who I interviewed recently, is headlining that. And then another band, Wicked, who I recently interviewed. They're cool as hell. They're going to be there. This is May 4th, 8 p.m. at Piper's in Pompano Beach. So it's basically my club. I'm taking it over. When I go there, I'm going like, hey, I own the place. My name's Piper. That's funny. I own the place. All right. So the next one is one of my favorites. With one of the best lineups ever. We're going to see how badly Rebel screws up the lineup. And that is Welcome to Rockville in Daytona, Daytona International Speedway, May 9th to May 12th. I'll be up there May 8th. There's going to be an official pre-party on the campground May 8th. And Rebel, read the lineup.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, so he won't be there. By the way, can you make that bigger?
Can't make that bigger, but you can on wherever your notes are if you went to
Ready? Motley Crue, Judas Priest, Anthrax.
Faster.
Yeah.
Oh, we reading all of them?
You got to do it fast, like Motley Crue, Jesus. I was about to say Jesus Christ, but it's Judas Priest.
Judas Priest, Anthrax.
You can't do it either.
Amigo the Devil.
Cold.
Point North. Disturbed. Oh, Lord. Mundane.
All right, we've had enough of you.
Thank
Disturbed, Mudvayne, Skillet, Flyleaf with Lacey Sturm, loving it. Saliva, Orgy, Imperial Toe, Kerry King of Slayer. It's his solo project. And man, he just came out with another new song. It is badass. And Biohazard, Lacuna Coil, one of my favorites. Shadows Fall, Stabbing Westward, Gideon Throne, Fuming Mouth, Machine Head, who is epic. August Burns Red, first mosh pit I brought my grandson into was August Burns Red. Soulfly, Buried Tomorrow, New Year's Day, Spite, Body Snatcher, Until I Wake. And then, like, what's that lower line? Can you see it, Rachel? I see bad wolves, miss may I, fleshwater, moon fever, TX2. I don't see the headliner though. What's the headliner?
Oh, wait, hold on. Putting on my glasses. Let me see.
Insane clown posse.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there it is. I knew I could count on you, Rebel. I knew it. You pulled through. How could you not?
That's hard one to
so
see.
So amazing.
That
it's good. Hey, have you ever gotten sprayed, Rebel?
No.
How about you, Rachel?
Sprayed?
Oh, yeah. You got to go to an Insane Clown Posse show, and I need you to be right in the front.
Oh, what did they spray you with? Blood?
Oh, no. It's better. It's better. Look it up. God. Rebel, tell us what they spray him with. Look it up.
I believe they spray you with blood and urine.
No, that's guar. Look up what Insane Clown Posse does.
Okay.
They're famous for it. Come on.
Really?
I went to their concert. I was there. I videoed from a distance.
I'll give you a hint. It's a type of drink.
Oh.
Okay, I'll start reading the rest while you guys find it. Limp Bizkit, Falling in Reverse, In This Moment, Star Set, Nonpoint, Flat Black, Power Man 5000, Jelly Roll, My Bro Jelly Roll. Man, he is killing it. He's winning awards everywhere. It's unbelievable. I interviewed him, and he goes around every press thing. He's like, yeah, Pipe Man's the only one that ever interviewed my daughter. His daughter was great. The Offspring.
I remember her. It was so fun meeting her. She's so talented.
Yes, she is.
Fagu? What is
Fagu? That's it. You found it, Rachel. Yeah. You found it. All right. There's so many good bands on here. I can't read them all. There's so many of them.
Mr. Bungle's coming.
Mr. Bungle, Cypress Hill, In Flames, Tech Nine, Code Orange, Clutch, Queens of the Stone Age, A Day to Remember, Foo Fighters, Greta Van Fleet, Slipknot, Breaking Benjamins, Architects, Evanescence, Bad Omens, Theory, Sum 41, Black Veil Brides. I mean, there's so many, I can't even list them all, okay? It's Living Color, man. That's old school, man. I'm Electric Callboy. They're so cool. If you've never listened to them, you got to check them out. What a great live show. Slaughter to Prevail has one of my favorite songs. I mean, the list goes on and on. Why don't we just play the commercial? I mean, this is ridiculous. We're reading off a list of 70 bands.
They can read it themselves.
That's right. Roll it, Juan. Be a monkey ranch. One more in peace than accident. I'd rather be than suffer this. I'll never be your monkey ranch.
That's crazy.
Badass. Can't wait for that one. I do have tickets we're giving away. So, again, if you call in 561-623-9429 or you direct message. And there's – hold on. There's a private chat here I got to look at. Champagne. What was that from?
What they thought they sprayed people with.
Oh, no. It's not champagne. It's what Rachel said.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So
– I have to make an announcement.
Yes.
For those of you who are timid to call in because of any way you may have been treated before, this is not that show. Please don't be scared. Hey, we're fun. Okay. This is a show.
Oh, I thought you were talking about me, but I didn't offend anybody. Thank God.
I have I have some people that just they're listening to the show, but they're skittish to call in because.
Oh no, we're gonna be nice to you. Don't worry, we'll be nice to you for sure.
Well, I can't promise niceness, but we're not going to.
Hey, Rebel, you remember this shirt?
There's no sharks.
Remember when I had the red red faux hawk? That's from when I had the red faux hawk, and I was wearing suits a lot of times back then too, but. It's just kind of stupid to wear a suit to a festival.
And hot.
All right. Before we go on to the last two festivals I'm going to talk about.
Cool.
I want to hear from Rachel. And I want to hear
about
her.
Rachel's neck.
I want to hear about her adventures recently. Not other podcast adventures, unless they're on this network, but any other adventures.
You got to be very specific.
In the past week, what adventures have you had?
The what?
In the past week, what adventures have you had you can tell us about? That people would want to hear about.
I don't know. Tell me.
You're no fun not drinking. You don't know.
I know. We're afraid to call in. Want to know what's around Rachel's neck. It's not a collar, people. She's wearing headphones that are.
Around her neck, not the head earbuds.
Yeah, it's just like this.
From what they're seeing, they thought it was a collar because it looks like the chain is going through your cleavage. That's not what it is, folks.
It's a collar.
That's the fans thing. But they are questioning what's around.
Can I pull on that collar from behind?
Sure. Let's see. I went, what are you talking about? When I went out and
anything you did that you want to tell the people about on the show? Like, did you lose your ability to tell stories?
No, I'm not. I just don't know what you're talking about because every day something crazy happens. So,
well, give us some of it before we run out of time on the show.
Okay, so let's see. Went out last weekend and to a Scott Gertner Sky Bar with a bunch of world travelers. That was really cool. Then my cousin boyfriend went on. He's on a trip to Palau, some islands very far away. And now I'm managing all of his properties, which is probably more than I can handle, but I'm doing the best I can because I don't want to disappoint my cousin boyfriend. And I got this. I've been doing a lot of shows and podcasts, but we don't want to talk about that. Can we talk about movie reviews and more last night?
I said, as long as they're on the network.
Okay.
Like, well, no radio station would ever promote anybody off their radio station. Just saying. It has nothing to do with you.
Rebel was the beaver. I was the peacock. And for some reason, Terry got really mad because she wanted to be the peacock. So she was like, and they were like, no, you're the shark. Because the guy asked, he's like.
That is more fitting, actually.
Yes. But he was like, anyway, he asked her, he goes, I don't know you, but I'm just going to guess here. Are you mean? She was like, so mad. No, I'm nice and I'm sexy and I'm a peacock. And we were like, okay.
Yeah, but female peacocks are not the sexy ones. It's the male ones that are beautiful. The female ones are nothing to look at.
Oh, I think when it's more like the peacock is like the showboat. Like,
You're definitely the showboat.
Yeah, I'm definitely the showboat.
And what else?
What else happened this week? I don't know.
What are you going to cook this week for the OnlyFans?
Oh, what am I going to cook? Well, I've got a rack.
You're a chef. You're a real chef.
So yesterday I did the salmon. It was beautiful. And sweet potato, Japanese sweet potato, and Caesar salad. Caesar is my family. A lot of people, I don't know if I've ever told you guys that, but Caesar Cardini, he invented the salad in Tijuana. So at a little hotel. And that's actually my cousin. So
another one.
Another one. And so I've got a rack of ribs.
Does this have anything to do with the... you know, the shows with the donkeys.
The flippity flip. OnlyFans. That's what's coming up. No, you're going to promise people weird shit like that.
I'm talking about what you're talking about. The salads. Like, donkeys?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, okay. That's what Tijuana's famous for. So yeah, curious. Did it have the worm from the mezcal in the salad? Because that would be a good idea.
No, it's anchovy.
Put the worm instead of anchovy, man.
Harry is trying to promote eating things. Well, you know, so
have you ever been to Tijuana and ate the worm at the bottom of a ball of mezcal? I did when I was 16.
I've never been to Tijuana.
Never get more drunk. You can't get more drunk. I mean, like, that is the pinnacle of
drunkness. I could definitely get more drunk than eating a flipping worm.
I'll bet you. That worm's been soaking in tequila for like years.
30 days, no drinking. And then after that, I will go out and find a bottle with the worm and I'll eat the worm. And
I know pro alcoholics that
I'm a face pro.
Plant.
Pro face alcoholics. Plant.
that face plant after eating the worm after a bowl of mescal.
The only thing that really has messed me up is the absinthe. And there's a guy here in Houston that has this magic show venue place, and he makes homemade absinthe. I was outside hanging out with the homeless guy who was painting my nails, and I thought that was completely normal. I did not want to go back into the magic venue. I was like, no, 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 I'm hanging out with my new friend. And then I just started walking down Bel Air at like 1 a.m. and strolled up into a McDonald's, sat on the curb, and I had cars coming up like, you know.
They thought you were homeless. They thought you were homeless too?
No, they thought I was a prostitute.
Well, I could see that.
It's horrible. It was.
Is
that what started the 30 days of no drinking?
It contributed to that. Yes. Yeah, that was definitely the next day. I was like, oh, I can't drink that. That was very bad.
Yeah, well.
Don't drink that.
Thank God I had my cousin to take care of me.
Speaking of drinking.
But he let you walk down the street to McDonald's.
He was inside the magic venue having a very good time. And requesting that I go inside. And I was, no, I'm just going to walk home. 2 hour walk home.
You're one of them.
No, and I'm not. See, that's just it. I'm not.
But the absinthe made you.
The absinthe.
Always blame it on the absent.
Oh my God. That'll take you to
all right. So speaking of drinking, on the next on the Pipeman Radio Tour, I'm going to Vegas.
Cool.
For punk rock bowling, one of my favorite festivals. It's so cool because it not only has punk rock, it has all these club shows too. It's not just a festival. There's all kinds of club shows starting on Thursday. So it's like Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. It's Memorial Day weekend, which is one of my favorite weekends. Punkers take over all of downtown Las Vegas. There's a bowling tournament. There's a poker tournament. And then there's the punk rock swim where a band plays while all the punkers are moshing in the pool with colored hair. It's the coolest shit ever. And now let's see how Rebel does.
Nope, I'm not doing it. Because this particular one is a really good one, and they do a lot of stuff. I'm not even going to torture any names or anything like that. You guys can read it right there on the screen.
All right, go ahead, Rachel. Let's see how you do.
Okay, the Descendants. We got Billy Bragg. We got Lag Wagon. We got the, what is that, Scatolites. We got the Street Party Stage. We got Bad Cop. Twist Off, Gorilla Biscuits, Madball 999, Teen Mortgage, the Iron Roses, Katie Overbay, and Backlash. Okay. And then we got Devo, very cool, coming in on Sunday. Rocket from the Crypt, the Subhumans, Destroy
One
Boys.
Of my favorite ever bands, the Subhumans.
Subhumans.
Go.
Okay. Street Party Stage. What is
Quicker.
That? NIS.
Quicker.
L.A. Slumlords, The Chat, Star Crawler, Snooper, Cosmic Psychos, Cat Bite, and Muertos Heist. Okay, next day, coming in on Monday, we got Madness. We got
so excited about that.
Gogol Bordello. We got the Stiff Little Fingers. We got Street Party Stage. We have Quicksand, English Beat, very cool. Scowl, Vile, Doll Riot, Bratmobile, Die Spitz, and Kate Clover.
Good job. All in downtown Vegas. Everybody join me for punk rock bowling.
Now
we're going to talk about one festival specifically that is not in May or April, but it kind of relates because it's punk rock bowling's Memorial Day, the beginning of summer. Then the end of the summer is Labor Day weekend, which is where we have my favorite camping festival, Rocklahoma. Cool. And,
are you going to
I'm not even going to talk about the lineup or anything. We're just going to run the freaking commercial.
Rocklahoma. Nightmare! America's biggest Labor Day party is back with the loudest lineup yet. This August 30th through September 1st in Pryor, Oklahoma. With, for the first time ever, Avenged Sevenfold. Slipknot. Disturbed. Evanescence, plus A Day to Remember, Lamb of God, and many more. Passes and camping on sale now at rocklahoma.com, starting at $10 down.
There it is. Are you going to camp out? So do you actually camp?
I do camp at that one. That one's badass for camping. I talked about that all last week, so I won't go over it again because we're running out of time. But, you know, they have strip club camping, they have boobs, they have bars, they have all kinds of things going on. The party is in the campground. And in that commercial, I just noticed there was somebody I'm almost positive I saw in the commercial, in the crowd, that's one of the photographers at the festival. So that was pretty cool. Now, let's end on a high note. We're going to end on the high note of this presidential bullshit. Okay? Okay? Because we're not even going to... We ran the commercial before. We might run it again. But it's pretty funny that we are about to elect a president that is on trial for a criminal crime.
And yet we have a sitting president whose family needs to be on trial for criminal crimes. But, nobody says impeach him.
Well, there's no proof of that. So, but there is proof of what, like, there's actual proof to have this trial. There's no proof
that Hunter Biden did what he did. None.
Yeah, really? Not that.
It's all over the news.
Yeah, but like, you're going to be responsible for your kids? Are you freaking nuts?
If I was responsible for my kids, he's not innocent. Oh no! We don't know.
I mean, I don't like them, but you know, listen. Unless you prove, there's so many people that talk so much shit about so many things.
We seen him sniffing children.
Yeah, and Trump also proved Obama was not American, but that wasn't true. So. I don't know. I didn't vote for him, but listen, our alternative to it, this is the first time ever a president has ever been on trial for criminal charges. So you got to be it's got to be pretty strong, because even Dick Nixon didn't go on trial. Okay. So it's got to be pretty strong. And of course, so let me tell you about the highlights of the trial, though, so far. They're not even in the trial yet. They're just picking jurors. Mm-hmm. The highlights are every day Trump has been falling asleep in the trial. So, like, he talks about Biden falling asleep during his speeches. If you're about to go to prison for the rest of your life, I think you would stay
boring.
Okay. And then the judge is getting upset at him with his speaking under his breath. Something grumbling under his breath, and the judge calls him out on it. And here's the best one of all. Audibly heard, this was audibly heard by the whole courtroom and probably the whole world, Trump farted on purpose during the picking of a jury.
Talk about clearing the courtroom.
Right? Also, there's a gag order in play for Trump that he violated, apparently, because he went on to Truth Social and start like 2 hours before going in the trial. He's like calling people, like, he said some shit that was pretty nasty.
Oh,
and
no.
Yeah, not good. You know, it's not even
he's like a real person.
It's like the drama is just it's not a real person, because a real person wouldn't do that shit.
No, a real person
does talk like he does, though. I mean, he has no filter for things. He just tells you like it is, or at least
he doesn't tell it like it is. He tells it like people that are his fans want to hear it, because
I don't want a real
somebody that traveled in his circle.
I want somebody better than me. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I don't have a filter. Yeah, I could say I can relate to him, but I don't want to run the country. You wouldn't want me to handle that job.
I don't want
somebody that has no filter being in charge. I'm not saying I want Biden. I don't want him either. I'm not voting, because those two fools are not. Neither
you're
one
not voting. That's why you have to vote for the pipe man.
Yeah.
Because I won't put up with any of that bullshit. And everybody is just going to have everything they ever wanted in life. That's my platform. And
virtually impossible.
We're not going to give it to you. You got to earn it like a real American. Okay.
Yeah.
Real Americans work their butt off and earn everything they get. They don't get handed out to them because I want to sit home and play video games. Okay. Yet we hand money to every other country in the world instead of our own. If we took all the money that we put everywhere else and put it to the homeless people in this country, we would cure the problem. Instead, we get the big pharma so they can create the problem. And I was just in a
stop giving it to big pharma.
I did a rebel when I got home. Okay. And I went into the bathroom, and there was a sign in the bathroom that said, "Don't use fentanyl. It's killing people." And I'm like, big pharma's giving this shit out, man. They're killing us. They chipped the pipe man, as you saw.
Chipped his penis.
Somebody.
Was not that?
No,
personally. But listen, if you vote for pipe man, if you vote for pipe man, I promise you that I will give you 3 days free on the Pipe Man OnlyFans. And so roll the commercial one more time.
Hey, folks, this is Bill Clinton. I listen to W4CY.com. And just remember, I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
Bring back the good old days, and I will have sexual relations with that woman. Vote Pipe Man for Prez.
There it is. Another Adventures of Pipe Man. I'm back in Florida. Oh, and by the way, I was at a restaurant yesterday for lunch, and I had to think, saying simple words like water and thank you, because I was about to talk in Spanish. And I was like about to say, you want anything to drink? I was about to say, agua, por favor. And then I was like, wait, she's going to look at me like I'm fucking weird. I should say it anyway. But then literally it took me like 10 seconds to think water.
English.
And then same way when she was bringing stuff over, I was about to say like gracias. And I held back, and it took me like 10 seconds before I was like, okay, thank you.
First meal that when you got back, what did you eat?
CPK. Well, that's not the first meal. That was yesterday's lunch. I had California pizza kitchen with cauliflower crust, a Thai chicken.
I don't know about all
pizza with cauliflower crust and a Thai crunch salad. But the first thing I did, believe it or not, is I didn't go out to eat. I go out to eat all the time. Mm-hmm. But groceries were not easy to come by in Costa Rica, and they were really, really expensive. Like, I bought a bag of grapes for $20.
What?
So the first thing I did was go to a grocery store, and I ate food from the grocery store. It was amazing. Yeah, I know we got to go. That's what I'm saying. All right. Hey, everybody, thanks for listening. Check me out on socials, Pipeman Radio. Enter to win tickets to Welcome to Rockville and Rocklahoma. And make sure to follow my Pipe Nuts here on socials. And hey, go to Pipe Man OnlyFans, and you can follow a lot more of the Pipe Nuts there. Thanks for listening. We will see you next week right here on the Adventures of Pipe Man W4CY Radio, 1 p.m. every Wednesday live, 8 a.m. every morning with interviews and other bonus content. Roll it, Juan.
Thank you for listening to the Adventures of Pipeman on W4CY Radio.